Hello dear students, our today's topic is Lamarckism, which is one of the theories to explain organic evolution. Organic evolution is defined as the process of evolution of primitive simpler forms of life into present day complex life forms by gradual changes. There are four important theories to explain the mode or mechanism of organic evolution, which include Lamarckism, Darwinism, the mutation theory, the modern concept of evolution, and out of these, today in this lecture, we'll take up this first theory, which is Lamarckism. Lamarckism is also alternatively named as the theory of inheritance of acquired characters, and this theory was explained by French biologist Lamarck in his book Philosophie Zoologique in the year 1809. And this was the time when most prevailing view was of the special creation, which believes that all the organisms or all the species present on earth, they are created by God, and these species, they have not undergone any change since their creation. But Lamarck, with this theory, he tried to prove that species are not constant, rather they are derived from the pre-existing species. And now let us take a look at the important postulates or important points of this theory, which explain the mechanism or the root of the evolution of new species from the pre-existing ones. The first postulate is new needs. Lamarck believed that any change in the environment of the organism, it can be in terms of the temperature, the scarcity or abundance of the food, the light conditions, etc. Any such change in the environment of the organism, it leads to origin of new needs for that particular organism. And now for adapting into his new environment, the organisms, it exert special efforts in its habits and its behavior for the purpose of adapting to its new environment. And now the second point is that अपना नए चेंज एनवायरनमेंट में अपने आप को अडेप्ट करने के लिए यूजली ऑर्गेनिज्म जो है वो दो तरह से अपने हैबिट्स में या अपने बिहेवियर में चेंजेस कर सकते हैं. फर्स्ट इज़ उस ऑर्गेनिज्म के कुछ बॉडी पार्ट्स या कुछ बॉडी ऑर्गन्स ऐसे होंगे जो उसके नए एनवायरनमेंट में ज़्यादा यूजफुल प्रूफ होंगे. सो नाउ द ऑर्गेनिज्म मेक्स यूजिंग more use or greater use of those body organs, and due to which these body parts, they become comparatively more efficient. And on the other hand, kuch body parts us organism ke aise ho sakte hain jo uske naye environment mein kam useful ho comparative to the earlier condition. So these body parts, now they are used comparatively lesser, due to which these organs, they can undergo degeneration or even disappearance. Now the next point of Lamarckism, it suggests that कि ये जो favorable characters organism अपने generation में acquire करेगा, अपने lifetime में उसको acquire करेगा, all these characters they are inherited to the next generation, due to which the offsprings of the next generation, they are born fit to face the changed environmental condition. And now the last point of Lamarckism is how the new species they are formed, which suggests that in every generation, as we just stated, that in every generation the new characters which are acquired, those characters, they are then transmitted to the next generation, and then these new characters, they keep on accumulating generation after generation. Ki हर एक जनरेशन अपने लाइफ टाइम में तो नए करेक्टर्स को एक्वायर करेंगे ही करेंगे. इसके अलावा ईच जनरेशन विल ऑल्सो इनहेरिट ऑल द करेक्टर्स विच आर एक्वायर्ड बाई इट्स एनसेस्टर. उसके एनसेस्टर्स ने जितने भी करेक्टर्स एक्वायर करे होंगे, वो भी हर एक जनरेशन में इनहेरिट होते जाएंगे, जिसकी वजह से आफ्टर नंबर ऑफ जनरेशन, बहुत सारे जनरेशन्स के बाद, दिस नंबर इट कैन बी थाउजेंड्स और लैक्स ऑफ जनरेशन, बहुत सारे जनरेशन्स के बाद उन करेक्टर्स का वो चेंजेस इतने ज़्यादा हो जाएंगे दैट द एग्जिस्टिंग स्पीशीज इज़ मॉडिफाइड इनटू अ न्यू स्पीशीज. सो दैट इज़ हाउ अ न्यू स्पीशीज कैन बी फॉर्म्ड. So it takes millions of years. So Lamarck, he suggested that speciation is a slow and gradual process. So these are the important postulates or important points of the Lamarckism. And now let us take a look at few of the important evidences which favor the this theory given by Lamarck. So first evidence in this category, it is the evolution of present day long necked and long forelimbed giraffe from a deer like ancestor which had small neck and small forelimbs. Lamarck believed that the ancestors of giraffe, they lived in the environment where the surface vegetation, it gradually started depleting. So in order to reach to the leaves of the higher trees, the members of each generation, they stretch their necks and they stretch their these forelimbs so that they could reach to the leaves which are present on the higher trees. They started stretching their neck and their forelimbs as long as they could. So in doing so, each generation would grow slightly longer necks comparative to the previous generation, and they will pass these traits on to the next generation, or to their next generation. So Lamarckism, this theory, it can very well explains the evolution of the present day giraffe which have long neck and long forelimbs. Other evidences to support Lamarckism include the presence of the vestigial wings in case of the flightless birds like ostrich, kiwi, penguin. All these flightless birds, they have evolved from ancestors which could fly, but their ancestor, because they started living in well protected areas with plenty of food, jahan par unko zyada fly karne ka, zyada flight ki unko zarurat nahi thi, so they continuously disused their wings, jiski wajah se their wings they converted into vestigial wings. Vestigial means vestigial organs are those organs which are present in the organism but they are non-functional. So in these flightless birds, due to the continuous disuse of the wings, their wings, they became vestigial. Other evidences of Lamarckism include the absence of limbs in snakes due to fossorial mode of living, and the presence of fast mode of running in case of deer due to continuous running efforts to protect themselves from the predators. So these are some of the evidences, but in spite of all these evidences, this theory of inheritance of acquired characters or Lamarckism, this theory is not fully accepted in the present times. This theory was strongly criticized by, for the first time, August Wiseman with his theory, which is termed as the theory of continuity of cytoplasm. Wiseman, in his this theory, he suggested that, and I hope aap sab logon ko bhi pata hi hoga, that organism's body, it consists of basically two types of cells, the germ cells and the somatic cells, out of which germ cells, they are responsible for heredity of characters to the next generation, and the somatic cells, they do not play any role in inheritance. Wiseman, he said that the environmental factors, they only affect the somatic cells, and environmental factors, they cannot affect the germ cells. So any character which is acquired by organism during its lifetime due to environmental changes or in effect of its environment, those characters, they will only affect its somatic cells, and as somatic cells, they are not transmitted to the next generation. So all such acquired characters, they must be lost with the death of the individual, and they cannot be inherited to the next generation. And to support his this statement, Wiseman, he performed an experiment in which he cut the tails of the rats continuously for 22 generations, and now had this Lamarck's theory, had it been absolutely true, then what should have happened, ki kuch generations ke baad aise rats ka birth hona chahiye jinme tail ho hi nahi, kyunki continuously bahut sare generations tak rats mein tail nahin ho rahe the, usme changes ho rahe the, but these tailless rats, they were never born. And same is the case with the boring or piercing of the pinna and the nose in case of Indian women generation after generation. And और हम लोगों को पता है कि never any babies they are born which have already pierced nose. So there is another very famous experiment which is referred as Pavlov's experiment, which also goes against Lamarck's theory of inheritance of acquired characters. But in spite of much criticism, Lamarck's theory is very significant theory of organic evolution in being first comprehensive theory for explaining the process of organic evolution. As well as Lamarckism, it also very well explains the existence of vestigial organs in certain organs and the presence of strong jaws, jaw muscles and claws in case of carnivores. And moreover, Lamarckism, this theory, it stimulated other biologists like Darwin to look up for the probable mechanism of organic evolution. So that is all about today's lecture, in which we studied Lamarckism or the theory of inheritance of acquired character. Thank you so much.